All right, let's take a look here at something called virtual private networks. VPNs, as they're called, are really a fantastic tool. I use them all the time, and they're a really great security tool to protect you personally, to protect the data on your computer, to protect your network traffic. And that's in a kind of on a personal basis, because there's two contexts. One of those would be just as a user on the internet, and you want to be protected. The other part of that would be protecting your company, because you might be working remotely for your company, and you want maybe you want to transfer documents over the wire, over the internet, or you're sending and receiving, you know, email or something like that, and you want that to be protected from things like eavesdropping or something like this. Now, obviously, there are measures in place where the encryption's already integral to the connection, such as if you were to use a Gmail suite or a G suite, which is a company level of Google services. Well, you're going to be connecting via HTTPS anyway, TLS, Transport Layer Security. That's already pretty secure. So you might not need to tunnel that using a VPN, but there you just never know. So it's always a better solution, kind of a belt and suspenders approach, to use both HTTPS or TLS and a VPN in addition to other security measures. All right, so let's take a look here at how this works out. First of all, just kind of on a personal level, okay? So let's say that this is you over here on the laptop, over on the right here, and you want to connect to the internet. Well, now, if you just do this kind of in the conventional way through your ISP and your Wi-Fi connection home, that's supposed to be an arrow. I don't know why I did that. Anyway, so in a lot of respects, you're pretty much unprotected. Yes, you can go to websites which are HTTPS, and by the way, fortunately, that's probably most websites nowadays, but there is still data that can be transmitted that could reveal things about you or identify where you're connecting from, or also to reveal your own IP address. Sometimes you don't want that to happen either. And you might say, well, I only go to reputable websites or something like that. Well, people that say that, I never believe them. That's just not what happens in real life. First of all, you might go to a website that is reputable, and I've done this in the past. I've seen this myself. Well-known website that gets millions of views a day and stuff like that. But the advertisers over on the side, a lot of times, that can be drive-by malware. And I haven't really explained that, and it's not really part of a current discussion. But it's where an advertiser will trick the website. This has happened to FoxNews.com, a couple of other news websites, ESPN. So big name websites, and they trick those websites into accepting an ad that has embedded in it some kind of malware, spyware, something like that. Okay. Well, we don't know that malware might need to know your IP address or want to know your IP address, or something else about you or your location in order to further launch some other kind of an exploit. So just going to, quote, reputable websites is not good enough. In addition, I just still don't believe people when they say that. You know, people will Google for stuff and they'll click on links that they've never seen before. They don't know where it came from. They just click the top two or three links that come up, and it's not always reputable. So those of you that say you only go to reputable websites, you know who you are. None of us believe you. Anyhow, so this is a dangerous. We don't really necessarily want that. Now, I almost always use a VPN. I'm not today because I want to show you how to turn one on later on and enable it and stuff. So if any of you want to hack me, today's the day to do it. Okay. Unfortunately for you, this is a recording. So anyway, there's my laptop. And when I connect to the internet, of course, that's not secure, but using a VPN service, I can connect through a VPN, and that creates this tunnel, if you will. Looks like an arm, doesn't it, with a big bicep on it. Okay. This is now an encrypted tunnel. It's a cryptographic tunnel. And in your mind, you can kind of picture a big concrete round tunnel that is impenetrable. Well, all your data is going through that. And there are a couple of other things that happen with this. So, for example, maybe my ISP cable modem over here in my house or my home office or whatever, maybe it's got a public IP address of, I don't know, 90.1.2.3. Okay. I always use kind of short IP addresses because I don't really want to write a lot. Anyway, plus you can't read it anyway. Anyhow, I might be using that And if I had just a normal bare internet connection, people could, or websites, destinations that I connect to, could see my specific IP address. Well, if I want to prevent that from happening and give myself some other benefits to VPNs, which we'll also talk about later on, I'll go through this tunnel instead. Now, when that happens, this VPN concentrator, they're usually connected through something called a concentrator. This is where a service will receive VPN connections from multiple hosts at once. Like VPN providers, they can connect, oh gosh, thousands and thousands of VPN connections all at once. Well, anyway, this VPN concentrator down here, it's going to identify itself publicly on the internet using a different IP address. So let's just say it's 6, I don't know why I can't write 6, 6.7.8.9. So, and then we access the internet and whatever other resources we want using this IP address, really. Okay, we don't have to be conscious of that. That's just how it happens, kind of behind the scenes. So now, if there's an evil internet dude out here that wants to exploit your connection somehow, all he can really see is this IP address. He does not see this IP address. Okay, so it layers an abstraction, adds a layer of abstraction to make it more difficult for the hackers. And, you know, even if they can eavesdrop on this connection here and pick any packets out of it, which is possible, it's definitely not that hard to do, by the way, especially over Wi-Fi. Well, they're not going to get anything useful out of it. It's just going to be encrypted garbage to them and really not easy to crack. Okay, some earlier implementations of VPNs and earlier encryption protocols have been exploited, but what we're using these days, it's awfully tough. So that's just kind of a quick rundown on how VPNs work and kind of an introduction into how they can be of benefit to you.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe here to get the latest from CBT Nuggets. Also, if you're new to IT or are interested in an IT career, visit cbtnuggets.com and sign up for a free trial.